Hey everybody, Dominic here, sporting my canvas t-shirt here, Think Big. It's definitely one of my favorite shirts that I own. So in this video, what I want to talk about are modules in Canvas and really just kind of give you a few recommendations and ideas about how modules work. In general, they're pretty simple, I think, to understand, but I think there's a few things that I can tell you that should help guide you in how to use them effectively. So let me jump over to one of my sandbox courses here. Modules basically are, the way that I describe them is that they are empty containers that you are going to fill with stuff. Okay. Let me go to my Let's Build a Course sandbox. And this is where I built my homepage in a previous video. I'm going to click on the modules over here to get to our modules area. Okay, so like I said, modules are basically empty containers. A module in itself doesn't really have anything to share. There's nothing there until we put pages and assignments and links and other content into the module. So again, they're basically like containers. And the real purpose of using them is to organize our content. I mean, if we wanted to, we could make a bunch of pages in Canvas that are in the pages area, a bunch of assignments in Canvas that are in the assignments area, discussions in the discussions area. You could do it that way, but then it's going to be very cumbersome for the student to figure out, okay, where should I begin? What should I do first? What should I do second? What should I do third? And that's what a module is for, to organize all that content together. I know that some people will actually choose to hide the assignments area or the pages area in their course to basically force people to go through the modules. I see some logic in that. I'm not sure that I would give a broad recommendation to do that, because I think there are times when it is logical to have those navigational items there. But modules are very important. Now, when you are building a Canvas course and you go to the modules area, you can create a new module by just hitting the plus module button in the top right. And when you click on that, it'll ask you to give the module a name. Okay. You can choose to lock your modules until a certain point in time. So I could say lock until and then put in a date. You can do that if you wanted to. Also, I talked in another video about using prerequisites and requirements with modules. The basic idea being you can give students an indication of when they're done with a module, and little green check marks will show up. That's what requirements do. And then prerequisites will actually make it so that a student cannot progress onto the next module until they've done all the stuff from a previous module. And if you're interested to learn more about that, you can look up one of my other videos that talks about requirements and prerequisites in Canvas. Now, once you create a module, it'll show up here. And I want to talk a little bit about the naming convention for a module. You can see that in this sandbox, I named my module Unit 1. I would actually not stay with that name. I would actually change that name a little bit. So here's what I would maybe do, and I'll explain why. So I'm going to go up here. I'll click on the kebab and click edit to edit this module name. And let's see. I mean, we could still call it Unit 1, but maybe then I'll put a dash and I'll say, if this was a Google training course, Google Drive. Okay, let's do that. Now, here's my rationale of the way in which I named it. First of all, if I say Unit 1 only, that doesn't really give much description of what the topic is of the module. So I would say it's good to provide a little bit of context of like, okay, well, what's Unit 1 about? That helps the student kind of frame in their mind, okay, this module is going to be about this particular topic. Unit 1 is one way to label it. Chapter 1 might be appropriate if you're going through a textbook. I would be careful with using time terminology. So like week 1, I would be careful with saying week one, week two, week three, even if you're giving the topic next to it. The reason I would be careful about that is because what if, now this might not be a problem in your area, but what if you built this course as, let's say, a 16-week course, and then the next semester you are going to teach it, but it's going to be accelerated into an 8-week course. Okay. Well, what's going to happen is you can import the content from your 16-week version into the 8-week, and you can tell Canvas to adjust the dates for you, but your modules are still going to be labeled as week one, week two, week three, when in fact, the students are probably going to be doing more than 1 week's worth of content in an 8-week course. I would avoid that. I would avoid using time as a label. I would either call it Unit 1. You could just give the topic if you were to do that. So let me just edit this quick. If I didn't want to say Unit 1, I would probably still say something like Module 1, Google Drive, if you can't think of anything else. But I think by doing it that way, it makes things more organized. A little bit easier for the student to understand what content they need to work on or what content they will be working on. And then the last thing I'll show you about modules is an extra bit of functionality. Let me actually go over to my real Google training course just to demonstrate this. Like I said before, a module is basically an empty container that we fill with different pieces of content. And you can see the finished product in my Google course here. I'll go to the modules area. So here you can see I've got these different modules. So you can see module one is Google Drive, module two, Google Docs, module three, Google Slides, and so forth. And if I want to add content to my module, I can just click on the plus sign. So if I wanted to add content for module two, Google Docs, I just click on the plus symbol up here. And I can choose what kind of content I want to add to that module. But the thing I want to show you is that when we put our content, be it a page, an assignment, a discussion, a quiz, whatever it is, when we put our content into a module, an extra piece of functionality will present itself. And that is, if I go to the first thing in the Google Docs module here, the Google Docs learning guide. So this is a page in the module. And if I scroll down to the bottom of this page, notice that at the bottom right is a next button. The only way that these buttons appear is if your content is in a module. And if I click on the next button, it will take me to the next thing in the module. Okay. And if I scroll down to the bottom and hit the previous button, it goes back to the previous thing. And if I am at the first part of my module and I hit the previous button, it'll actually go back to the module before this one and show me the last piece of content in there. Okay. So that's just kind of a general overview of how modules work in Canvas. I would highly recommend making sure you have all of your content in modules. There might be some exceptions to this for those courses in which the LMS is more of just like a repository of information and there's not really a lot of content that needs to be organized that way. There might be exceptions there, but by and large, I would say we should use modules just as a way to keep stuff organized for our learners. So, if you have any questions about using modules, any questions about Canvas in general, feel free to reach out to me or another member of the CPD department. And remember, think big. All right. Thank you very much for watching. See you guys later.